Aligarh Muslim University is able to contribute and respond to its mandate. There is a mandate in the Act of AMU stating that the university should strive for the educational and cultural advance of the Muslims of this country. That clause was lying idle in the Act ever since 1920. Until 1972, the Act had given a provision only to establish schools within a radius of 25 kilometers or other institutions. When the Act was changed by the Parliament, they have created a new opportunity wherein Aligarh Muslim University will be able to open centers without any geographical limit. Since 1972, although that provision was available in the AMU Act, we were not able to unlock the potential. So when the Sanjar Committee report was approved by the Parliament and there was a dire need to initiate affirmative actions, AMU received a number of representations around that time. The first letter came from the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh and the President of the Garib Nawaz Foundation in Bhopal. Another letter that was sent to the Prime Minister was from West Bengal by Sri Buddhadev Bhattacharya, the Chief Minister of West Bengal at that time. Both these letters were forwarded to Aligarh Muslim University with a direction that you may examine this within the framework of AMU Act and get it approved by various statutory bodies. And that was the beginning of this grand exercise. So the idea of establishing AMU centers has captured the imagination of the Indian Muslims, and it has ignited a new hope and aspiration across the country. That is why we are during the 12th plan. So this money, if we want to establish a center with all the modern facilities, we have to invoke the spirit of philanthropy also. Those who know Aligarh University knows pretty well that Sir Syed Ahmad Khan had traveled the length and breadth of this country seeking funds for raising AMU. We have seen that the Aga Khan had contributed millions of dollars at that time. Still, Aga Khan also went around the world seeking funds for establishing AMU in Aligarh. So, if you come to AMU campus, you will find every building was conceived so magnificently at that time. After independence, we could not construct a single building like that. So, prior to independence, it's all done based on philanthropy. Huge amounts. Every hostel is built by one individual or the other. There is a hostel built by Nizam. And then no one who had not contributed that time. Every brick you can find a name done by somebody. So the center, if it is coming up in Aurangabad or Malegaon, it also has to evoke the spirit of philanthropy from all segments of the society. So I am very optimistic that we will see both the sides and we will give the best of consideration based on the available facilities in the respective location. Now we have no idea about the size. Inshallah, we'll leave tomorrow morning by 7 o'clock and inspect the land and return by evening. And we will communicate the decision within a few days' time. The moment the land is given to us, Aligarh is in your midst. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.